This is Quest Banjo Verdome. I'm going to stop from this end, work them back. There's a lock to put an arrow on it. So I know where I'm going. What direction the left's are going to go. Then I'll pick a external squared up. And I'm going to measure my center line. The back of the spouting. There you go, 45. bulk of rail all that, and then you can come back and do the fine, fine cutting. Makes it a bit easier as well, rather than trying to go on the line from the very start when you've got the feed firm the whole thing up. It's a bit hard. It takes a little bit longer doing all this, but you know you'll have it right. Okay, just want to get that cut out. You need to break, when they've got the bead on like that, you need to break the bead. You do that by screwing it across. Putting a mark there, getting a little foot by a screwdriver and a hammer. Break the bead like that. Throw him around. That's how we see it, it's going to get it pretty good. Put your external brackets just in to make sure you look for your square. Bring it over. Be a long second, I want to take a look at it. There. You can get your pencil and scribe up this lap here. It's worked out exactly where I originally had a mark. Put your little cut in here so you can fold that lap around. Trim metal is all about trying to leave it all on to the last possible second so you know exactly what's in the way and what isn't. If you cut it off at the very start, you've got no chance of getting it back. This is wrecked. You fold it over a little bit more than 90. The hole there really nice for you. Try and do a little bit. Something like that. Did they stick a rivet in it? Thank you. is that? Put a few nicks into this bit here. When it's all together, then you can tap that around a bit. There's your internal angle. Doesn't count too bad. And then from there you guys stick some more rivets in. Don't worry about that. Alright, then you come to the external angle. The measurement is from the back, from that back corner, this back corner, to the next corner where it's going to fold around, needs to be 350. And I'll reach back. Now that point there is the start of your V, right? Because when that folds around, that's gonna end up being your back corner. That mark there, yeah. So from that point, you're 45 from there. Come down the face of it. We break it back. Square up, going 45, square up the bead. Just like before. Something like that. No. You can do the same with the working out the bead as the same before. Make sure you go right the same right way with the bead. Point the line makes up, make sure it's parallel with the bead. Scribe through all that. So where that bead reaches the roll, that's going to be your centerfold there. So from there you can go back the other way. Work out to the next side. Bead comes in, square up, put that ruler into there, like that, see how the 45 is going to go. Then same deal again with the external angle, so okay, we've got to come up. The direction of flow is going that way. Need to have our laps on this side. Lap on the back, because this one's going to get cut in two bits. On this one, you leave a little bit on this side of the roll, and leave a fair bit, because then you cut that off right at the end of the whole thing together, and that'll lap in the face of it. There we go. Let me cut that out. with this extension, because it's going to end up in two bits, you best stop cut it in two bits right at the start with just the axle. Come straight down rather than trying to get the snips in hard position. When you're cutting this bit up here on the back of the corner, you need to cut it so this flap, you use these snips, so this, the back side of the flap will fold around, which is the way it wants to go, and you cut just a slit up here, even a little bit more this side of that fold. Something like that. So I've sort of cut right just a little bit above that fold there, because later when that all comes together, you've got that back corner there, that's where you're going to end up. So you've got that little bit of material there to tap over to cut the hole if there's one occurs. Corner button into it. But they're going to be looking at it, they're looking for it. are banging into each other for a little bit longer. Not all of it. Square, you get a square to make sure it's all square. Same thing with the rivers going around the other one, you can just drill them out later. It's a lot easier pulling it from this side than trying to flip them over and maybe distorting the whole thing when you push your drill into it. To get him nice, you just cut him back. Cut him back down under the way so it gets under that bead. Under that bead and that. Make sure you don't drew yourself in a hand here because it's a good place to do it. Daggy bit here at the end of it that we left long. You can come back now and trim that. Shoot him up a little bit. Get as small as you can sort of get it. Thank you. together. When you put the gaskets on, that'll pull together pretty well. There it is, something like that. Also, what I was saying before, when you're cutting that back lap, so you got your little corner in here. I haven't got a hole here, but if I did, tap down there, it's like a saving grace kind of thing, yeah. So a little bit in there, what I was talking about before, when you're cutting the back lap.